All right, let's use the Wallace's formula to evaluate the integral of cosine to the power of 6x from 0 to pi over 2. And just to remind you, Wallace's formula is only applicable for the interval 0 and pi over 2. And fortunately, we have the intervals in both part A and part B, 0 and pi over 2. In one case, in fact, you have the even power of cosine. In part B, we have the odd power of sine. I want to do like two exercises in one shot in one video. So let's just do that all together. So by the way, you can always change the cosine function in the formula by sine. Okay, so just keep that in mind. Okay, so I have in part A n to be 6. So it is an even number. So let's check what the pattern of the right-hand side looks like. So you have 1 over 2, 3 over 4, 5 over 6, all the way to n minus 1 over n, pi over 2. So the question is like, where are you gonna stop? So when n equals 6, this term becomes 5 over 6. So that means I'm going to keep this, keep this, keep this. And then I'm not going to have 7 over 8 anymore, but I'm going to keep also pi over 2. So I can go ahead and write this as 1 half, 3 quarters, 5 over 6, and pi over 2. Okay. So that is, if you multiply those numbers, it's 5 over 32 pi. Okay. That takes care of part A. In part B, we have the odd power of sine. Power is 9. So let's see how the pattern looks like in the first formula. N is odd. N equals 9. All right. So the last term looks like 9 minus 1, 8 over 9. So I'm going to keep all the ratios here. So let me just continue from here. Okay. I'm going to keep all the ratios and then the products here till I hit 8 over 9. Okay. Yep, that's where I stop. I would not continue with 10 over 11 anymore because my n is 9 and the last term should be governed by me putting in 9 for n. So the last term should be 8 over 9, okay? And you can go ahead and simplify this. I would not recommend you to use the calculator to have the final ratio, but first, get the ratio by multiplying these fractions, and then you should be able to get 128 over 315. If you want to, you can just like get a decimal number by using your calculator for this value. But at this moment, we just leave it as the exact expression. It's 128 315. All right. So this was a short video. Wallace's formula is quite strong. And you can apply this formula to other functions, other sine or cosine functions raised to the power of n and could be even or odd. The only thing you have to pay attention is that the interval has to be 0 and pi over 2. And if you just pay attention to that and you get the result in one shot, in fact, we got the result in one shot for two cases, two different integrals as well. Okay. All right, I think that's the end of the video. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in another video. Bye.